everyone, welcome back to the channel. So today I'm doing something really different, like really different for me. I'm gonna rate Lady Gaga's new album. So obviously I love music, everyone knows that I am obsessed. All I do all day while I'm meant to be writing my thesis is mime to songs, sing to songs, send Snapchats of me doing that to other people who then don't respond because no one actually cares. But anyway, I thought I would go through the songs on Lady Gaga's new album, react, rate, and you know, give you my review on her new album. So obviously she hasn't released an album since Joanne, which I fucking love that album so much. Best album, love it, it is great. But yeah, let's see what we've got. So the first song is called Chromatica, which is the name of the album. I think it's just an intro. Yeah. I mean, that is kind of like the tone of the whole album. Like, it's got really kind of a mix of like orchestra and like techno-y pop in the back, which I like, but was an intro for 1 whole minute needed of just that? Maybe not. But we can't fault the queen. And then another song, next song on the album is called Alice, which... Yeah, so the next song is called Alice, which... I like the idea behind it. So it's like, you know, her name is Alice, she's looking for Wonderland. Who fucking isn't? But it kind of just sounds really similar to a few of the other songs on the album, so I didn't really like remember it. Do you know what I mean? Like, I listened to this album yesterday and I didn't remember it as being that amazing. So I'd probably rate that song like a 5 out of 10. That's why I'd rate Alice. I'm sure I'll warm up to it more, but for now, initial thoughts, 5 out of 10. And then we got Stupid Love, obviously, which is her most recent one. Which, again, I do like, but I wouldn't say it was groundbreaking. But no, I do like the song. I think it's been overplayed because I've heard it so much on the radio. But yeah, it definitely fits like the theme of the album, very futuristic kind of vibe. But I do like that song. 7 out of 10 from me. Next we have, obviously, the song I'm going to rate 10 out of 10, Rain On Me. Wait for it, it's Ariana's bit. Living in a world with something's innocent. So yeah, I love this song. 10 out of 10 from me. I literally am obsessed with Ariana and Lady Gaga together. The videos they're doing on Instagram are hilarious. Love her. So next we have one called Free Woman. They all have just like the similar vibe, don't they? Kind of like echoey techno vibe. Yeah, again, I like this one, but not that memorable. I would rate that 5 out of 10. And we've got Fun Tonight. Ooh. Ooh, I like this. Yeah, I feel like... Let me play a bit more. Oh, okay, so she's talking about not having fun tonight. But it's called Fun Tonight. I would say you were going to have fun. But still, you know, whatever, Gaga. Quite like that song, though. Probably rate that one a 7 out of 10 as well. Feel like that's a bit different. Oh, and now we have Chromatica 2, which I feel like is another... Maybe an interlude? Yeah, definitely an interlude. Again, that's fine. Bit boring, but... Yeah, the whole kind of theme is, like, orchestra mixed with techno mixed with futuristic pop. That is literally how I would describe it, which I kind of love. She's kind of made like this whole world of Chromatica. But yeah, I feel like some songs sound so similar they've blended into one. Like Stupid Love sounds, it kind of sets the vibe for how they're all going to be, and it kind of blended into one with Alice and Free Woman. Fun Tonight is a bit slower, which I kind of like, and I'm liking, just like that vibe a bit more. Rain On Me, I was just going to love, wasn't I? This one's called 911. Do we have an emergency up in here? See what I mean by techno? I feel like I'm in Daft Punk's brain right now. Oh, I quite like this one. Okay, yeah, that one is a bit more, it's even more techno, basically. What shall I rate that one? I'll rate that one maybe an 8 out of 10, because I feel like I'm gonna get into that one and I'm gonna get obsessed with that song. Right, the next one's called Plastic Doll. Bit of a weird name. Giving me Pretty Little Liars vibes from the Dollhouse season. Yeah, again, kind of just sounds the same. Rate that 5 out of 10 as well. Yeah, some of them really do just sound the same, but other ones are just like a bop. Oh, this one, for example. This is called Sour Candy, and it's with Blackpink, like a K-pop band. Yeah, I love this one. I'll rate that 10 out of 10. Really like that one. I listened to that a few times on repeat. Then we have got Enigma. It's a very long album, you know. Oh, I like this one because you can like really hear her voice. I like when you can hear more of her singing voice rather than when it's really techno, because her voice is amazing. Love her long time. This is Replay. Oh, I liked this one yesterday as well. Yeah, I'll probably rate that one an 8 out of 10 as well, because really like that. We've got another interlude. What are the points of interludes? Like, I mean, is it just extra music that they want to shove in, or is it because it's telling a story as an album? I'm going to go with the second one. Oh, this song, love this. This is called Sign From Above, and it's with Elton John. And it's... kind of about finding yourself and looking for a sign from above. Yeah, I love this one. I feel like Elton and her voice goes together very, very well. Love Elton. Elton is the best. Right, Thousand Doves. Oh, I liked this one as well, actually. Yeah, I love that one. See, like, they all have the similar vibe, but there's like a few that really stick in my mind, which, for example, this one is it. So again, a solid 9 out of 10 for you. And then the last one is called Babylon. Babylon? Okay, so this is giving me like old Gaga vibes. Because she kind of like talks in her songs, doesn't she? Where she's just like... when she's just like, baby, you were born this way. Like, she like, kind of says some stuff, and she kind of is saying her words there, and I love it. So yeah, I like that one as well. I'll give that one an 8 out of 10, mainly for the throwback of old Gaga. But overall, I think the album is great. It kind of like tells a story. Some of the songs do blend into one because they have really similar sounds. But overall, I'd probably rate it an 8.5 out of 10. I think if there was some more, like, more different songs, I would have rated it higher. And if there was some more throwback to the old Gaga, again, higher. But, yeah, I'm going to go 8.5 because I really like the one with Elton John, the one with Ariana, the one with Blackpink. And I also really like Thousand Doves and Fun Tonight and 911 are the other faves. The actual, like, Stupid Love, which obviously came out a while ago. I think I've just heard it too much. And then a few other ones kind of blend into sounding similar. But overall, fucking sick album. And I love the like kind of costume and makeup that she's done with it to create the whole Chromatica world, living for it. I feel like Lady Gaga is so good at doing that. So yeah, I'm gonna rate it an 8.5 out of 10. Definitely go listen if you enjoy Lady Gaga. I fucking love her. But yeah, that was my opinion, reaction, reviews to the songs on Lady Gaga's album. I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to give it a big thumbs up, subscribe, comment down below if you like me doing kind of reviews of albums. I'll do some more. Like, I literally listen to albums all the time, new ones, old ones. If you want me to rate it, I will do it. Yeah, so go over to Instagram to Brush Up and Blush Up to see all my other looks. You can go on my Twitter, TikTok and Facebook, all Brush Up and Blush Up. And yeah, I hope you have a good day and I will see you in my next video. Bye guys.